अस्सलाम वालेकुम, माई नेम इज़ शज़ा अली। माई रोल नंबर इज़ BP1650210। आई एम पार्ट ऑफ द मॉर्निंग ग्रुप नंबर 25। अवर टॉपिक इज़ क्रोनिक ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव पल्मोनरी डिजीज़ COPD एंड माई टॉपिक इज़ मॉडरेट COPD। COPD refers to chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, which is chronic inflammation of the lungs in which the person has obstructed airways. Due to the blockage in the airways, symptoms include breathing difficulty, cough, mucus production and wheezing. This disease generally refers to emphysema and chronic bronchitis. Emphysema is pathologically characterized by alveolar wall destruction and air space enlargements in which air is trapped inside the alveoli. Chronic bronchitis is defined as chronic cough, which continues for at least 3 months for 2 consecutive years. Its pathological hallmark involves inflammation and fibrosis of small airways. It is extremely important cause of morbidity and mortality. As we can see in the picture A, there is healthy alveoli which are of normal size and there is no air entrapped in it. In emphysema patient, air is trapped in the alveoli and alveoli are also enlarged. In the picture B, we can see healthy relaxed small muscles with open airways, while in chronic bronchitis there is sputum or mucus present inside the smooth muscles are tightened and have inflammation. Risk factors of COPD include cigarette smoking, which is a major risk factor. Other risk factors are cofactors with smoking in COPD, such as occupational dust and chemicals, indoor and outdoor air pollution, certain infections including respiratory viruses, as well as infection with human immunodeficiency virus. Pathophysiology is airflow obstruction, which is caused by COPD. It is usually progressive and attributed to pathological changes like it affects the lung, proximal airways, peripheral airways, lungs parenchyma and pulmonary vasculature. Diagnosis and patient assessment includes diagnosis of COPD can be done by spirometric testing. It is based on presence of risk factors, generally smoking and clinical symptoms. Airflow obstruction is checked by spirometric testing. Symptoms include cough, wheezing or dyspnea on exertion persists. General management of this disease includes only interventions that have proved to reduce mortality in COPD are smoking cessation. We can also give patient oxygen therapy with severe hypoxemia patients and lung volume reduction surgery for very selective patients can also be done with advanced emphysema. Pharmacotherapy medications can only slow the progression of the disease. They cannot completely cure the disease. The general guidelines will apply as patients with COPD begin to require pharmacological treatment. Patients will eventually require daily maintenance therapy for sustained periods, unless adverse effects of medications increases. The number of medications will communicatively increase as disease worsens. Individual variability in medication response is expected and requires careful monitoring. Some of the medications that are used in bronchodilators and glucocorticoids. Classification of COPD is, it has 4 stages, stage 1, stage 2, stage 3 and stage 4. Stage 1 is very mild, and then we have moderate, severe and very severe, and they have different values predicted as in terms of FEV1. Case study for moderate COPD is there is a woman which is 46 year old named J.O. with a 32 pack per year history of cigarette smoking, presents with increasing shortness of breath. She gets winded walking on level ground after about 100 yards. She quit smoking 2 years ago. The chronic cough that she previously had lessened after smoking cessation, but the dyspnea is now somewhat worsened despite use of an albuterol inhaler on a PRN basis. On examination, mild wheezing is noted. Our CXR is unremarkable. Office spirometry demonstrates an FEV1 and FVC of 0.54 and absolute FEV1 of 2.0 liters or 60% predicted. Post bronchodilator treatment is done. Increase by 100 ml, a 5% increase is shown. How should JO be treated? We have SOAP notes here. Subjective is that the age of the woman is 46 years old. History is 32 cigarettes pack per year smoking. After cessation of the smoking, there is decrease in cough. Chief complaint is shortness of breath. Chronic cough improved somewhat after quitting smoking, but dyspnea is worse now. Current medication is albuterol inhaler and post bronchodilator treatment is continued. Objective. Lab test which is done is spirometric test, FEV1 per FVC of 0.54 and FEV1 of 2.0 liters or 60% is predicted. Assessment. Ms. J.O. is showing symptoms of increasing shortness of breath. As she walks on the ground about 100 yards, she feels shortness of breath and coughing. Although she has quitted smoking 2 years ago, her dyspnea is also getting worse despite of having inhaler on BRN basis. She's examined due to the complaint of shortness of breath, and mild wheezing is also noted, which predicts that she is suffering from moderate COPD, which is also called as gold stage or stage 2 COPD. Plan. Ms. J will still show progression of dyspnea despite cessation of smoking. Short-acting beta-2 agonist should be added because pharmacological management of COPD involves a stepwise approach. If beta-2 agonists, which are short-acting, not show good results, we can start the use of long-acting bronchodilators. Regular use of long-acting bronchodilators is the next step in the treatment. We will prescribe sarmatrol and formoterol as they show improved pulmonary function, reduced dyspnea and enhanced quality of life in patients with COPD. Doses of sarmatrol and formoterol. Sarmatrol 45 mcg and 50 mcg in a dry powder device twice daily can be given, and formoterol 12 mcg twice daily. We can also give tiotropium, which is actually anticholinergic and works on M1 and M2 muscarinic receptors. It is also a quaternary amine with limited systemic absorption. Therefore, there are less side effects and they are well tolerated by the patients. The side effect which is included in tiotropium is dryness of mouth. JO should be started on a long-acting bronchodilator such as sulmetrol, formoterol or tiotropium. JO should also be instructed to continue her albuterol 2 puffs every 4 hours PRN. A 3-month follow-up visit should be scheduled to assess her response. Conclusion is sulmetrol and formoterol shows improved pulmonary function, that's why they are prescribed. They show reduced dyspnea, so that we can deal with the complaint of the patient having dyspnea, and enhanced quality of life in patients with COPD is seen. Inhaled long-acting beta-2 agonists relieve symptoms and improve exercise tolerance and health status for our patient. It should be noted that tolerability and efficacy of the available long-acting bronchodilators are comparable. The choice of agent is largely based on considerations such as the frequency of drug administration, the patient's ability to use the inhalation device correctly, and any out-of-pocket costs incurred by the patient should be considered.